Light in our bar.
Excuse me, sir. Excuse me. Hello.
Excuse me, sir.
Excuse me. Sit down.
Ladies and gentlemen, we request you to stand up and welcome our chief guest for the evening, His Excellency, Honorable Governor of Maharashtra, Sri Ramesh Bias. Everybody, big round of applause. We request our guest of honor, Sri Mukesh Ambani, Chairman and Managing Director, Reliance Industries Limited, to join us on the dais on stage. Shri Vipul Shah, Chairman, GJEPC, please join us. Shri Anoop Mehta, President, Bharat Diamond Bourse. And Shri Milan Choksi, Convener, Promotions and Marketing, GJEPC. May we request our dignitaries to please take their seats on the dais. Well, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Tonight is a very special, momentous occasion as we gathered here to celebrate the 50th edition, the Golden Jubilee of the India Gem and Jewelry Awards, IGJA, organized by Gem and Jewelry Export Promotion Council, the GJEPC, as we call it. The event this evening is powered by GIA, Gemological Institute of America, the world's foremost authority in gemology, and our knowledge partner is Ernst & Young. Since our inception in 1974, ladies and gentlemen, IGJA has been an emblem of excellence in our industry. It has been recognizing entrepreneurial spirit and innovation. And every year, IGJA honors best of the best, showcasing pinnacle of achievement in the gem and jewelry industry. Originally focused primarily on diamonds, precious stones and gold jewelry, the IGJA has evolved over the years to embrace newer categories, reflecting the dynamic nature of our industry. Tonight, ladies and gentlemen, at the 50th edition of IGJA, we commemorate 50 years of brilliance and we celebrate our remarkable 50-year journey. Thank you, everybody, for joining us on this very special occasion for us. What makes this even more special is our ties on stage. Thank you so much to our chief guest, our guest of honor. Thank you for joining us. May we request you all to please come forward to light the lamp of knowledge.
Excuse me, Baju. Excuse me, just come out here.
We wanted to start the evening by lighting the lamp of knowledge. Thank you so much, dignitaries, ladies and gentlemen. Now we request you all to please rise for the national anthem.
Shishamage, Yahe Tavajan.
धन्यवाद. कृपया बैठिए. हिम्मत मैं आप सभी से विनती करूंगी हमारे स्टेट सॉन्ग के लिए, महाराष्ट्र सॉन्ग के लिए सॉरी एक बार फिर प्लीज खड़े हो जाए. थैंक यू.
Keeping up with the tradition of having distinguished personalities to present the award this year, we are privileged to have two remarkable luminaries gracing the dais today. It is with the utmost honor and gratitude that we acknowledge the presence of Sri Ramesh Paris, the Honorable Governor of Maharashtra, and Sri Mukesh Bhai Ambani, Chairman and Managing Director of Reliance Industries. Their presence not only dignifies our event, but also serves as a source of inspiration and motivation for our trade. Our industry finds remarkable parallels with these two eminent personalities. Sri Ramesh Paris has an illustrious career and has played diverse leadership roles. Similarly, the visionary leadership of Sri Mukesh Bhai Ambani resonates with the industry's dedication to innovation and advocacy for Make in India. From the humble beginnings in 1966, GJEPC has led the industry to emerge as a global leader. From a mere $28 million, today we proudly boast of a staggering $40 billion in exports, a testament to our relentless pursuit of excellence. India is the undisputed leader in cut and polished diamonds, with 14 out of 15 diamonds set in jewelry worldwide processed in India. Additionally, we are the leading exporters of gold jewelry, silver jewelry, colored gemstones, and lab-grown diamonds. Over the last 5 decades, GJEPC has been instrumental in nurturing the gems and jewelry industry through 360-degree approach. It has played a pivotal role in driving the vision of making India the preferred source for quality gems and jewelry. Driving export growth and employee welfare has been the two key pillars of our mission. International trade development is showcased throughout international trade fairs, IGX Dubai and IGTS Dubai, that have driven global market access. Our flagship show, IIJS, the world's second largest show, serves as a showcase of India's gem and jewelry craftsmanship, attracting buyers not only from India but also from across the globe. Over the years, Council has served as a pivotal bridge between the trade and the government, facilitating pragmatic trade-friendly policies. Today, industry boasts a workforce of over 5 million. The Council not only fosters business growth among its members, but also champions the welfare of the employee through initiatives like Swasthya Ratna, Swasthya Kosh. While the gem and jewelry industry has made significant contributions to India's economy, what often goes unnoticed is its extensive involvement in philanthropic endeavors. Whether collectively or individually, the industry has played a pivotal role in advancing society, supporting several philanthropic initiatives and social causes. GJEPC has achieved the significant milestone of 10,000 members, showcasing the growing recognition and trade the industry places in the Council's ability to advocate for the interest and promote growth opportunities. Moving forward, the industry's trajectory aligns closely with our Honorable Prime Minister Sri Narendra Bhai Modi's vision of a prosperous and a sustainable India. GJEPC has been wholeheartedly committed to this cause, actively undertaking initiatives to drive growth and sustainability. From establishing key infrastructure such as Jewelry Park in Mumbai, Gem Booths in Jaipur, and Mega CFC in Sindh, to skilling the next generation, GJEPC will continue to provide conducive environment for the industry to scale new heights in the future. These efforts not only contribute to the industry's expansion, but also ensure its alignment with the principles of Viksit Bharat. Together, let us embark on the next 50 years with renewed vigor and passion, ensuring that the India gem and jewelry industry continues to shine as a leader in the global arena. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Sri Vipul Shah. Thank you, sir. Moving on, ladies and gentlemen, it's my honor and pleasure to now introduce and welcome to speak our guest for me. How does one really introduce a trendsetter, a leader, a visionary, a global powerhouse? The Chairman and Managing Director of Reliance Industries Limited, under whose leadership RIL has turned into this global powerhouse with diversified interests across energy, petrochemicals, textiles, retail, and telecom, and many more. Please join me in welcoming none other than our guest of honor. Big round of applause for Sri Mukesh Ambani, everybody.
Most respected Governor Ramesh D. Paris, Vipul Bhai, members of the Export Promotion Council, distinguished guests this evening, ladies and gentlemen. For me, it's a pleasure and a privilege to be invited to this function and to be a part of it. Thank you, Vipul Bhai. Our most respected governor has spent over 40 years in public service and has had an impeccable record, and Maharashtra is fortunate to have a governor like him. Sir, your presence this evening enhances this function. Thank you. To the members of the gem and jewelry industry, as a businessman, I have to admire what you have achieved. You really represent the true meaning of entrepreneurship and enterprise. You are in an industry where, as India, we don't have diamonds, we don't produce gold, and still you use your enterprise, and through your enterprise and Indian talent, you have created a very large industry over the last four decades and have continuously been among the top three industries of exports from India. You now have the opportunity to really be the champions of Make in India, to add value, to represent Indian design, Indian concepts, Indian talent to the rest of the world. As Vipul Bhai said, I'm very proud that from a very modest number, today you contribute $40 billion in export and over 5 million in employment. My salute to each and every one of you. This industry, and particularly the diamond industry, started out of Palanpur. And it is said of the Palanpuris that they don't share their businesses or their daughters. Their businesses go from one generation to another, and their daughters only go to their community. We were fortunate 5 years ago that Russell's daughter Shloka came to Ambani. All my friends really thought that Nita is a great diamond picker, and she picked Shloka, right, from the Palanpur family. But unfortunately, they were all wrong. It was Akash and Shloka who were in school together, and we didn't very much realize their romance. So Shloka is the true diamond from your industry and from the Palanpuri industry in our family, who radiates warmth and wisdom for all of us. So as I was walking in, I just asked that what is the composition of the gem and jewelry industry? And now I realize that we are Kathiawadis. So sometimes partnership between Kathiawadis and the Palanpuris only make the opportunity bigger, right? And the bigger the pie, the better for all of us. Ladies and gentlemen, let me start off by warmly congratulating each and every award winner this evening. My heartfelt congratulations to each and every one of you. I want to pay a special tribute to Russell on winning his Lifetime Achievement Award. This same award was won by his father, Arun Bhai, in 2007. And following the footsteps of a giant father, as all of you know, B. Arun Kumar was a pioneer in this industry. And still, making your own mark is a daunting challenge. And as son of Dhirubhai, I know that very well, Russell. So, really heartfelt congratulations for this achievement. We are all very proud of you. It makes us particularly proud because you've not only grown the business, you've also grown his values. And you maintained and enhanced the values on which Rosy Blue was established and built. I particularly admire your commitment to the community. I'm always in awe. In terms of every time I ask Russell, what are you doing? So he says, I'm going to attend this wedding, this community piece, this, all this. He keeps like, you know, I'm like between him and Mona, their commitment is truly outstanding. But what I even admire more is what you have done for Palanpur and the CSR activities and the two schools that you have established. And it's amazing to see products that come out of them. And you introduced us to Pranav. Pranav is in the audience today and he is a product of your school today, a world technology leader, coming out of the work that you do. So both of you should be proud. We are very proud of Pranav and I hope that Akash and Pranav make India proud of you. So it's not only the business that you do, but all the work that you do, we admire. And for all of you who don't know Russell, he is a quiet and an introverted person. But I can tell you that when he speaks, all his words are genuine. So you have to listen carefully to him. And he is the most reliable among our nearest in the family. If you tell Russell something once, it just gets done. So the jury has picked the right winner. My congratulations to the jury also. Finally, let me congratulate again the Export Promotion Council and all its members on their 50th year. And the potential that you have, I'm sure that over the next many decades, you will reach your $100 million target. And all of us collectively in the business community have a responsibility to build a stronger, better, and a more inclusive India to fulfill the vision and the goal that our Prime Minister has set for us, that of a Viksit Bharat, a fully developed India in the next decades. So with that, thank you very much. Jai Shri Krishna.
Ladies and gentlemen, I give you a big round of applause to our guest of honor this evening, Shri Mukesh Ambani. बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद. Thank you so much for your encouraging, insightful words, sir. Moving on, everybody, our friends, our distinguished guests in the hall this evening, let's move on to the highly anticipated 50th edition of IGJA, India Gem and Jewelry Awards, our Golden Jubilee, ladies and gentlemen. We are very excited to share this moment with you, and the first award is even more special. We are going to be felicitating the Lifetime Achievement Award. I'm not going to say anything, I would just let this video, this AV, speak for itself.
Rosan Mehra, Managing Director of Rosy Blue India, firmly believes that strong work ethics and passion are indispensable for achieving success and sustaining the enterprise through the decades.
I congratulate GJBC on the decision to select us for the prestigious award. I cannot think of a more deserving candidate. Rosy Blue has over the past 7 decades not only been one of the largest and most respected companies in the industry, but have been top shareholders of our team. Rasade is ensured to take this remarkable legacy forward, constantly thinking ahead, considering the industry's growth and not just his own, and dealing with great challenges.
What an appropriate award on the 50th year of award function to recognize Rasade Bhai Mehta, who is leading Rosy Blue, one of the most leading concerns which has put India into the world diamond industry map. Right from the mines to market, Rasade Bhai knows the entire industry so well.
He's down to earth, easily approachable, and always ready to help the industry whenever need arises. He has maintained the legacy of his father, Arun Bhai, probably first father and son duo to get this coveted award from him. Good luck and congratulations to Rasade.
Rasade Mehta is a chip of the old block and still puts to practice the lifetime lessons that his father, the renowned and respected diamond Arun Bhai Mehta, imparted.
And as Rasade Bhai, to our diamond industry, me, एक विष्णु पिता बोलो या एडवाइजर बोलो या तो फ्रेंकली बोलो या रियलिटी कहने वाले हैं, क्योंकि बहुत सालों से जेमन ज्वेलरी में भी वो सक्रिय है, वाइस चेयरमैन रह चुके हैं, भारत डायमंड बूट्स में भी वो बहुत एक्टिव है. सभी इंडस्ट्री का जो भी प्रॉब्लम होगा, छोटा हो या बड़ा हो, ऊपर तक गवर्नमेंट तक जो बात किया हुआ और उसका सोल्यूशन निकाला हुआ नॉलेज के साथ, वो बहुत सारा काम रसल भाई ने किया हुआ है.
रसल भाई जितने शाम स्वभाव के है, वो व्यवसाय में एवं संचालन में उतनी कुशल और भाई, उन्होंने देश विदेश में अपनी कुशलता से नाम किया है. वहां तक पहुंचना अपने आप एक चुनौती के समान है. अंत में इतना कहूंगा, रुकना मत, खुद अभी थक कर मंजिल और काफी है, यह तो बस एक पहला है, फ्यूचर तो अभी बाकी.
मेहता हार्बर्स अ डीप पैशन फॉर डायमंड्स. For him, a diamond is not merely a commodity, but a unique product that is woven around emotions.
I was fortunate to have closely worked with Rasade Bhai during my tenure as a GJBC chairman. He was my advisor throughout, offering invaluable guidance and support. Rasade Bhai has a profound understanding of the industry and his clear vision greatly helped or decision-making processes. I express my heartfelt gratitude for his support and congratulations on his well-deserved Lifetime Achievement Award.
Big congratulations to you, Rasade Bhai Mehta, for this Lifetime Achievement Award. I think you've deserved this for many, many years, and it usually means that you're retiring from the industry, but I think you're very, very far away from retiring, and you will always be a friend, philosopher and guide to this wonderful industry. And I am personally humbled and happy to have known you for so many years at such close quarters.
Hello everyone, Russell, my dear friend, congratulations on your lifetime achievement. Achievement Award. But hey, let's get one thing straight. Lifetime Achievement Awards do not mean that you're done yet, right? This is just another milestone in your journey of greatness. Your leadership at Rosie Blue, a very strong partner of De Beers, and your contributions at the DJEBC have been nothing short of legendary.
Dear Mr. Mehta, I'd like to congratulate you on behalf of El Rosa and myself on receiving a remarkable award, which highlights your singular contribution to the jewelry and gemstones industries, as well as the global diamond industry. You deserve a great deal of credit for the current industry's success and accomplishments. We truly appreciate your deep engagement with the Gem and Jewelry Export Promotion Council. I sincerely congratulate you and wish you many more years of productive work, brilliant triumphs, kindness, and wealth on behalf of the entire El Rosa team.
He believes that his aim is to evolve into a better person every single day, since he is his own competition.
What I think about his life is that he's a unique combination of a great teacher, a teacher of humility, a teacher of what is long-term, teacher of what is partnership, teacher of dealing with people as to where they sit, not necessarily where we sit. And it really, there's someone who I very proudly call a friend. And for me, for my teams, both at De Beers and Mount Goldberg Council, it's been an amazing experience to have him around us.
You are one of the pillars of the glorious Indian diamond industry. We are founding the Rosie Blue Empire, one of the largest diamond companies of the world. You always found time to give back to the community through your work with GJEBC. You guided and encouraged generations of Indian diamondeers, some of whom are leading the global industry today.
Ladies and gentlemen, today it is my great pleasure and honor as we celebrate the outstanding achievements of a true visionary in the diamond industry, Mr. Russell Mehta, Managing Director of Rosie Blue India. It is rare and happy coincidence that both father and son have been recipients of this esteemed award. The late Arunbhai Mehta, respected diamonder, and Russell Bhai's father, were honored with the GJEBC Lifetime Achievement Award in the year 2007. This shows that Russell Bhai has carried forward his father's illustrious legacy. Russell Bhai's visionary leadership has propelled Rosie Blue to new heights and also inspired countless others in the field. On behalf of the GJEBC and the entire diamond jewelry industry, I extend my heartfelt congratulations to Russell Bhai on this well-deserved recognition. May his legacy continue to inspire generations to come. Thank you.
May I now request the awardee, Sir Sri Russell Mehta, to please join us on stage for the Lifetime Achievement Award. Sri Russell Mehta, Managing Director, Rosie Blue India. The celebrity, to please hand over the Lifetime Achievement Award. May you please achieve this. His Excellency, Honorable Governor of Maharashtra, Sri Ramesh Bhai, and our guest of honor, Sri Mukesh Ambani, to please hand over the award to our Lifetime Achievement Award. Sri Russell Mehta, Managing Director of Rosie Blue. Sir, please say a few words and share with us how you feel in this moment.
Wow. Well, thank you. Thank you so much. His Excellency the Governor of Maharashtra, Shri Rameshji Vyas, India's pride and beacon of entrepreneurship, Shri Mukesh Bhai, the Gems and Jewelry Export Promotion Council, extremely grateful and humbled with this honor. I am nothing but the culmination of blessings of my grandparents, teachings of my parents, love and support of my dearest wife, all my six children and grandchildren, and of course my larger family. Unwavering backing of my partners and my team, especially my son Raj. Camaraderie of my industry peers. So today, I humbly accept this honor on all of their behalf. Natural diamonds and jewelry are always associated with happy occasions and are a symbol of enduring love. That is why I am so passionate about this amazing industry, as it always brings so much joy to our customers. I am extremely fortunate to be the son of the most revered diamondaire, Shri Arun Kumar Mehta, who was awarded the Lifetime Achievement Award in 2007. I hope that I have made him proud by following in his footsteps. This is for you, Papa. Let me today reiterate my commitment to this industry, our people and our consumers, to always aspire to try harder and do better so that the luster never dulls. Once again, I express my humble gratitude to our industry, which has given me so much, and the Gems and Jewelry Export Promotion Council for this recognition. Thank you very much.
Many, many congratulations for a lifetime of excellence and contribution to the industry. Congratulations, Shri Russell Mehta, Managing Director, Rosy Blue India. Well deserved, sir. Thank you. Before we start the next set of awards, may I request Shri Kirit Bhansali, Vice Chairman, GJBPC, Shri Sriram Natarajan, Managing Director, GIA India, and Shri Sabyasachi Ray, Executive Director, GJEPC, to kindly join us on stage. We shall start with our special recognition awards. Ladies and gentlemen, and the first award in the special recognition category is Highest Taxpayer Company, and the winner is on the screen. Kiran Gems Private Limited. May I request you to please join us on stage? Kiran Gems, Highest Taxpayer Company, as a special recognition. Ladies and gentlemen, is for the highest turnover. And the highest turnover winner on the screen. Once again, Kim Jen. Thank you.
Moving on to our Industry Performance Award segment. In the Industry Performance Awards, the first award is for Cut and Polish Diamonds Large Exports Rs. 1000 crores and above, and the winner on the screen. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, Kiran Jain. Southern Polish Diamonds medium exports above rupees 250 crores up to rupees 1000 crores, and the winner on the screen. Give it up for Dhanira Diamonds! Dhanira Diamonds! Exports below rupees 250 crores, and the winner is Upal Diamonds. Upal Diamonds, congratulations. Above rupees 250 crores, precious metal jewelry, plain, large exports. Congratulations. And the winner is... Give it up for Hasmukh Parmik Jewelers. Hasmukh Parmik Jewelers. Precious metal jewelry, plain, medium, exports above rupees 100 crore up to 250 crores. And the winner is Ashok Jewels Private Limited. Ashok Jewels. Large exports above rupees 500 crores and above, and the winner is Jewelex India Private Limited. Jewelex India Private Limited. Thank you. precious Indian jewelry studded medium. Exports about rupees 100 crores up to 500 crores, and the winner is Kiran Jewelers. Give it up for Kiran Jewelry. SME exports below 100 crores, ladies and gentlemen, and the winner is Shri Momai Krupa Jewelers. Shri Momai Krupa Jewelers. Silver Jewelry and Industry Performance Award. Please give a big round of applause to the winner in the Silver Jewelry category, Renaissance Global Limited. Cut and polished colored gemstones, and the winner is Vaibhav Global Limited. Vaibhav Global Limited. Fashion jewelry. And in this category, ladies and gentlemen, costume fashion jewelry, the winner is Amrapali Exports. Synthetic stones, and the winner in the cut and polished synthetic stones category is Industrial Jewels Private Limited. Industrial Jewels Private Limited. Lab-grown diamonds, highest exports. Lab-grown diamonds, highest exports. And the winner is Green Lab Diamonds LLP. Green Lab Diamonds. Thank you.
responsible company, which is for CSR, gives us immense happiness to announce the winner in the CSR category. Please give a big round of applause for Lakshmi Diamond Private Limited. Awards. Our next award is for highest employment on the company rules. Please put your hands together for the winner, Emerald Jewel Industry India Limited. Emerald Jewel. Emerald Jewel Industry India Limited. US and Canada, highest gems and jewelry sales importer, US and Canada, and the winner is Unique Designs Incorporated, Unique Designs Inc. Everybody, Unique Designs. Our next award is for the highest gems and jewelry sales importer, Asia, other than India, highest gems and jewelry sales importer, Asia. And the winner is Kiran Exports Hong Kong. Kiran Exports Hong Kong. And the winner is Kiran Exports NV. Kiran Exports NV. And our next one is for Best Innovative Marketing and Branding Campaign Overseas. And the winner. At the 50th edition of IGJA, we have a very special segment for the women entrepreneurs and their contribution. Please join me in welcoming the winner of our Women Entrepreneurs segment with a big round of applause, Women Entrepreneur of the Year, Mrs. Hina Vimal Dhoda from Sri Avadh Krupa Jewelry. Thank you.
The best bank financing the industry, ladies and gentlemen. Best bank financing the industry. Highest growth of limit sanctioned within minimum base of 500 crores. And the winner is IndusInd Bank. IndusInd Bank. Recognition award presented to GJ EPC employees for 25 years of dedicated service. Please put your hands together for Shri Prashant Mathre, Senior Manager of Accounts. Shri Sanjay Dhotre, Senior Attendant Admin RO Mumbai, and Shri Jawaharlal Yadav, Senior Attendant Admin RO Delhi. Thank you so much. And with this, we come to the final of all our awards. Together for special recognition for our GJ EPC employees who have marked 25 years of dedicated service. Shri Prashant Mathre, Shri Sanjay Dhotre, and Shri Jawaharlal Yadav. That marks the end of all of our awards. It is a big round of applause to all the winners. And may I request our esteemed chief guest, ladies and gentlemen, His Excellency, Honorary Governor of Maharashtra, Sri Ramesh Bais, to please say a few words. Can we give a big, big round of applause to our chief guest, His Excellency, Honorable Governor of Maharashtra, sir.
पांचवें भारतीय रत्न एवं आभूषण पुरस्कार इस कार्यक्रम में उपस्थित श्री मुकेश अंबानी जी अध्यक्ष रिलायंस ग्रुप श्री विपुल शाह अध्यक्ष रत्न एवं आभूषण निर्यात संवर्धन परिषद किरीट भंसाली जी उपाध्यक्ष मित्तल चौकसी जी निमंत्रक अवार्ड कमेटी अनुप मेहता जी अध्यक्ष भारत डायमंड बोर्ड श्री रशेल मेहता जी प्रबंध निर्देशक रोजी ब्लू तथा लाइफटाइम अचीवमेंट पुरस्कार विजेता रत्न आभूषण निर्यात पुरस्कार विजेता सदस्यों आमंत्रित देवियों और सज्जनों रत्न और आभूषण उद्योग के सदस्यों की सफलता और उपलब्धियां मनाने के लिए आयोजित 50वें इंडिया जेम्स एंड ज्वेलरी अवार्ड समारोह के अवसर पर आपके मध्य में उपस्थित रहकर मुझे खुशी हो रही है। भारतीय उद्योग के प्रोधा श्री मुकेश अंबानी जी का हार्दिक स्वागत करते हुए मुझे बहुत खुशी हो रही है। रोजी ब्लू के प्रबंध निदेशक श्री रशेल मेहता को उनके योगदान के लिए लाइफ टाइम अचीवमेंट पुरस्कार प्रदान किए जाने पर हार्दिक बधाई देता हूं। वर्ष 2022-23 में उत्कृष्ट एक्सपोर्ट परफॉर्मेंस के लिए चुने गए अवार्डी सभी पुरस्कार विजेताओं को भी मैं राष्ट्र के प्रति उनके योगदान के लिए हार्दिक बधाई देता हूं। रत्न एवं आभूषण निर्यात संवर्धन परिषद देश के निर्यात को बढ़ावा देने के लिए सरकार द्वारा शुरू की गई सबसे महत्वपूर्ण और मैं कहूंगा कि सबसे प्रभावशाली निर्यात संवर्धन परिषदों में से एक है। मुझे यह जानकर खुशी हुई कि जल्द जरूरी एक्सपोर्ट प्रमोशन काउंसिल की सदस्य संख्या 9600 है। सरकार और उद्योग के बीच एक इंटरफेस के रूप में तथा पॉलिसी निर्माण में जरूरी एक्सपोर्ट प्रमोशन काउंसिल की भूमिका काफी सराहनीय रही है। जानकर प्रसन्नता हुई कि जरूरी एक्सपोर्ट प्रमोशन काउंसिल हर साल दुबई और जयपुर में इंटरनेशनल जेम एंड ज्वेलरी उत्सव का आयोजन करती है। परिषद से मुंबई में एक भव्य एकीकृत इंटीग्रेटेड अंतरराष्ट्रीय रत्न एवं आभूषण उत्सव आयोजित करने का आह्वान करूंगा, जिसे दुबई महोत्सव की तरह एक भव्य आयोजन बनाया जाए। मुंबई भारत की आर्थिक राजधानी है, वैसे ही यह भारत की फिल्म राजधानी भी है। मध्य पूर्व से कई लोग अपने इलाज के लिए मुंबई आते हैं, तो मुंबई मेडिकल टूरिस्ट डेस्टिनेशन भी है। इस प्रकार के संयुक्त अंतरराष्ट्रीय मुंबई महोत्सव में रत्न एवं आभूषण उत्सव के अलावा सांस्कृतिक कार्यक्रम, फैशन परेड, फूड फेस्टिवल, फिल्म फेस्टिवल का भी आयोजन किया जाना चाहिए। सदियों से भारत अपने रत्न और आभूषण, हीरे, कलर, जेम स्टोन आदि के लिए जाना जाता था। कई अरब राष्ट्रों के साथ भारत का पर्ल आभूषणों का व्यापार था। इस क्षेत्र में हमारी महारत इतनी अधिक थी, भारत के कोहिनूर को दुनिया ने सराहा। भारतीय आभूषण डिजाइनों की पूरी दुनिया में सराहना की गई। वर्ष 1961 में इंग्लैंड की महारानी एलिजाबेथ द्वितीय ने मुंबई का दौरा किया था। फरवरी 1961 में 3 दिनों के रानी एलिजाबेथ तथा ड्यूक ऑफ एडिनबरा प्रिंस फिलिप राजभवन में रहे थे। महाराष्ट्र के तत्कालीन राज्यपाल श्री प्रकाश और मुख्यमंत्री यशवंतराव चव्हाण ने एलिजाबेथ को फेयरवेल गिफ्ट के रूप में कोल्हापुरी साज नेकलेस उपहार में दिया था। साथ ही ड्यूक को तुतारी बजाने वाले कलाकार की चांदी की मूर्ति भेंट की गई थी। तो आपको बिना कोई भी वीआईपी विजिट पूरी होती ही नहीं। आज जब भारत रत्न और आभूषणों में ग्लोबल लीडर बनने की आकांक्षा रखता है, हमें अपनी मौलिकता और शिल्प कौशल को बनाए रखने और संरक्षित करने का प्रयास करना चाहिए। हमें पारंपरिक सुनारों और हीरा तराशने और पॉलिश करने वाले कारीगरों की रक्षा करनी होगी। जेम्स एंड ज्वेलरी उद्योग जगत के अंतिम व्यक्ति के कल्याण की चिंता हम सभी को करना चाहिए। राज्य के 27 विश्वविद्यालयों के कुलाधिपति के रूप में मैं खुशी से हमारे विश्वविद्यालयों और कॉलेजों के साथ मिलकर काम करने की अपील करूंगा। रत्न और आभूषण उद्योग में छात्रों के लिए ट्रेनिंग प्रशिक्षण का शुरू करने का आग्रह करूंगा। महिलाएं जेम्स एंड ज्वेलरी उद्योग के सबसे बड़े उपभोक्ता है। अब समय आ गया है कि महिलाओं को रत्न एवं आभूषण कारोबार में हित धारक बनाया जाए। हमें महिलाओं को उद्योग में नेतृत्व के पद संभालने के लिए प्रोत्साहित करना चाहिए। मुझे यह जानकर खुशी हुई कि रत्न एवं आभूषण निर्यात संवर्धन परिषद नवी मुंबई में एक आभूषण पार्क स्थापित कर रही है। मुझे यह भी जानकर खुशी हुई कि हाल ही में सिर्फ मुंबई में भारत रत्न मेगा कॉमन फैसिलिटेशन सेंटर का उद्घाटन किया गया। मेगा कॉमन फैसिलिटेशन सेंटर उद्यमियों और छोटे व्यवसायों को बढ़ाने और फले फूलने के लिए एक सहायक और सहयोगात्मक वातावरण प्रदान करेगा। भारत रत्न सीएफसी विधान छात्रों सहित कारीगरों के लिए प्रशिक्षण और कौशल भी प्रदान करने जा रहा है, जो वाकई सराहनीय है। मैं कामना करता हूँ और आशा करता हूँ कि वर्षा का झंडा पूरी दुनिया में लहराने के लिए अनुसंधान, विकास और नवाचार पर जोर देगी। मुझे विश्वास है कि आप ब्रांड इंडिया को गुणवत्ता, विश्वास, नैतिकता और उत्कृष्टता का उपनाम बनाने में हमारी मदद करेंगे। फिर एक बार मैं सभी इंडिया जर्नी अवार्ड विजेताओं को बधाई देता हूँ और परिषद को उनके भविष्य प्रयासों में सफलता की कामना करता हूँ। जय हिंद, जय महाराष्ट्र।
बहुत-बहुत धन्यवाद, थैंक यू सो मच टू आवर चीफ गेस्ट सर, थैंक यू सो मच फॉर योर एनलाइटनिंग मोटिवेटिंग वर्ड्स सर। मे आई नाउ रिक्वेस्ट श्री किरित भंसाली, वाइस चेयरमैन जीजेईपीसी टू डिलीवर द वर्ड ऑफ थैंक्स। कैन वी वेलकम मिस्टर भंसाली विद अ लाउड राउंड ऑफ अप्लॉज।
The humility, with which you have accepted it, your commitment, your dedication, your great legacy, and your life and your idea for all of us here. Thank you all. Thank you all for the support and results. I heartily congratulate all the recipients of awards. You have not received just an award today, but it is a gateway for your progress in the world of javelin gallery. I'm certain, using your skills and hard work, you would scale your heights in future. As I conclude, I would like to once again thank each and every one of you for being a part of this historic occasion. Thank you, Jai.
Thank you. May we request our GTVPC committee to please come forward. Can we request you all to please come forward for a group photograph? It's our 50th edition of IGGA. Can we request dignitaries for a quick photo op? Group picture, let's capture this moment.
Excuse me. Hello.
And this, ladies and gentlemen, marks the 50th edition Golden Jubilee of IGJA.
Hello!
Sabya Sachi sir, may we request you to please join us. Thank you. What a memorable moment. With this, thank you so much to our chief guest and our guest of honor. Bahut bahut dhanyawad. Aap sabhi ko ek baar phir se main vinanti karungi, kripya aap apni seat pe khade ho jaye. Rashtragaan ke liye, we shall play the national anthem again. May we request everybody to please stand up to commemorate the formal closing of this event. We will play the national anthem. Request everybody to kindly stand up. Thank you. Thank you, Shri Mukesh Ambani ji and Ambani family to join us. Thank you so much, all of our delightful guests. Congratulations to all the winners. Please join us for dinner. Dinner is being served in the pre-function area. We request everybody to please join us for dinner. Dhanyawad.